What's up, everybody? If you remember from last time, we were doing Wilhelmina Forest, and I had a bit of a problem getting the displaceable sawmill in here. Well, it turns out I was using an older version of the map. I never did upgrade to the latest version. But anyway, that's what the issue was, and I've got the... I used the Place Anywhere mod to get the sawmill finally placed in here. But if I had upgraded to the latest version, I wouldn't have that problem. But anyway, got to figure it out. So what we're going to do this episode is I want to get the sawmill going, and so that means we need logs and we need wood chips to put in over here. And I think what I'm going to do for the wood chips, let's see, let me find a good spot here. I've got a placeable mod. We may have to clear off some more trees though. Let me look and see over here on this side if there's a good place to put anything. You know, it might fit right over here. Let's try and see what happens. Let's see, I think it's maybe under miscellaneous. Yeah, there it is. Okay. And we do have enough money. So let's go over here. Or actually, I was looking over here when I... Yeah, I don't think it's going to like that. And we can't put it there because it's already got something. Okay, we may just have to clear off some more land and flatten it and whatever. Because, just don't have enough room to work with, but that's okay. So, let's see here. The first thing I need to do is I need to get... I flattened out this land so much. Look how tall we are now. So I got to get a way of getting up here. So, let me... get this fellow buncher out of the way. Just gonna back it off into the woods here somewhere. So anyway, once we get all the terrain where we can get up to the sawmill corrected, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to do a time lapse of the next little portion of the rest of the video is going to be time-lapse. What we're going to do is get logs added to the sawmill so we can get going. I've got a full load of 100,000 liters of wood chips right here ready to go. And so let's we'll do a little time-lapse in that part. Let's see, let me get over here. And oh yeah, I guess it's the Q in the, yeah, there we go. Hardly ever use this terrain sculpting stuff, so. And now I forgot what's. what changes the radius. Okay. There we go. Alright, so let's just kind of bump that up a little. Or a lot. Wow. I really knocked that up quite a bit, didn't I? Okay. So if you watched my tutorial about making a map, same kind of rule applies here. We're just going to have to do like a little stair step kind of method. I'm just smoothing it out right now, trying to get like a little ramp built up here. It looks like I'm going to have to come over here and... Yeah, it's not letting me do much with that part right there. So I think I'm about to cut a tree over there. Yep. I'm just trying to build a little ramp up here to get to the sawmill. That's not the greatest, but I don't think that's gonna work. Okay, so I'm gonna have to get this tree right here out of the way. Which means I'm gonna need the fellow buncher. I might as well just start cutting, because we're gonna have to get all this cut anyway. All that to get to this one tree right here. That was the problem tree. Okay, now let's see if we can sculpt that like we need it. Okay, that might be good enough. That might work right there anyway. Let's see. Let's see if I can get, yeah. Now I just messed up everything I just did. I don't like the way it flattens it out. I just told it to go up. Not flatten. I hate that this thing actually burns so much money. It's really burning through the money quick. Just trying, all I'm trying to do is flatten this terrain. Okay, yeah, it's not the greatest, but I think that'll work. Yeah, I think that'll work right there. Let's see. It's not the best right here on this corner because we're kind of at a going up at kind of an angle there. Let me see if I can bump that up a little bit more. All right, I think that'll work. Yeah, that'll be fine right there. Oh, that's perfect. Okay. All right, let's see here. Let's get the log truck, the chip trailer truck up there. We'll dump that into the sawmill, get it going. We'll get the skidder to grab us some logs. I'm not even gonna worry about processing. I'm just gonna skid the whole tree up there. And at some point we'll have to have us... Well, actually, no, they got the little spout thing over there we can load up the wood chips. I was going to say we have to get us a front-end loader, but we don't have to. All right, so in goes the wood chips, and I think we only need like 10,000. Maybe they changed it. It used to be 10,000 liters. Let's see what happens here. There's six... Wait, that's more than... Okay, they did change. That's way more than 10,000. Let me put the whole 100,000 in there. Yeah, 100,000. Okay, cool. Alright, so we got wood chips. And I think what I'm going to do is just go ahead and park this trailer right here under the wood chip output. Call it output. So once the sawmill gets up and going good, it'll start to output wood chips into this holding area, but we're just going to go ahead and park the truck right there. Got our wood chips in there, we just need some logs, so I'm going to hop in the skidder, which kind of got buried in the ground. Trees on the ground to get us going for a good bit, but I am going to cut down some more trees eventually and just kind of stockpile them into a spot hopefully. And we should be good on trees for a while, and then I'll set up the wood chipper over there at some point. We'll get the wood chipper set up, and then start making some wood chips to use to put in there, because it'll output some, but it may be enough to sustain the operation. We'll just have to see it when we get going here. I don't want to buy the wood chipper thing just yet. I thought I was going to need it, but then I got to thinking, I think it sustains itself, the sawmill. I can't wait to use this on my 4X map at Ransom Ridge, because the way I've got it set up is I've got the production sawmill in there as a placeable, and what you'll have to do is whenever I get the map finished, there'll be two or three different mods you have to have to play the map like it's intended. And what I mean by that is I'm going to have the production sawmill like we have here in there. But my sell point, really the sell point for the lumber is going to be in town at the lumber store. And so you got to truck the lumber all the way across the map to town. So I'm looking forward to that, because that's going to be a lot of fun. And it's a great drive, too. I can't wait for y'all to see that drive. It's kind of like a twisty, windy mountain road. Sucked up a little bit. There we go. It's going to be an epic drive. from the production sawmill to the town. And the drive to the other sawmill is not bad either, but it's just the highway is really, really cool. Closest that has the chain on it gets sold, it sort of releases the rest of it. That's alright. Okay, so you can see the little pile of logs that kind of starts to appear over here, and it'll tell you up here how many, I'm not sure what units that is, but down here in this little input area, see it says only 4% of logs, and we got 66% of fuel, so we've already used a little bit of this wood chip over here, supposedly. Or maybe it holds more than 100,000, I don't know, but I guess it does. That's what that means. Alright, let's see. I'll come back along this road and pick up some. Alright, so from this point on in the video, I'm going to switch to the time lapse. And I'm just going to be picking up logs and, you know, putting them in the sawmill. And then at some point, I'm going to buy a... Yeah, I got enough money. I'm going to buy a truck and the flatbed trailer that's got the auto loader for the pallets. I'm not going to worry with trying to use a, you know, some sort of a loader, forklift or wheel loader with a, you know, pallet fork on. I'm not going to worry about that. I'm just going to auto-load it. I've messed with those pallets for too long, and I'm just tired of them. They're hard to work with. I'm tired of messing with them, so I'm not going to use that. But anyway, hope you enjoy the rest of the video, and we will see you again on Wednesday with probably a different map. But until then, thanks for watching, and we'll see you later.